Hey everyone, it's Jacqueline at Pixie Dust PhD. Recently we got some very exciting news about new Disney Vacation Club villas at the Polynesian, so we'll go over what we do know and we'll do some speculation in this video. Stay tuned. It's no secret that I love the Polynesian. If you watched my ranking video, it was pretty high for DVC, and just in general, we end up spending a lot of time over at that resort even when we're not staying there, which we haven't stayed there yet, so yeah, I mean, I'm very excited about this news. I know not everyone feels the same, but let's go over some facts before we get into feelings, opinions, and speculation. The press release was actually very slim on details, so they are expanding their Disney Vacation Club villas at the Polynesian. This is projected to open in late 2024. It will be a tower. There will be additional rooms, new recreation options, and new dining options. But in terms of facts, that's really all we know. They did also share this artist's rendering. Several press outlets followed up since this news release, and they did confirm that the Spirit of Aloha show will be closed forever. It is going away. Essentially, this tower is going in the same place as Luau Cove, so Spirit of Aloha can no longer operate. A lot of people are very bummed about this. I never did Spirit of Aloha. It looked very expensive, and as a person that grew up relatively fortunate on the West Coast, I've been to Hawaii a handful of times. I've done a real luau, so I've never felt the need to do Spirit of Aloha. I'm sure that is a loss, but we also are getting new dining options, and the press release does say options plural in the new DVC tower at the Polynesian, so I'm really looking forward to what those will be. As is for the DVC portion at the Polynesian, there are 380 villas, with a vast majority of those being studios, and then just a handful of those bungalows. I think it's safe to assume, though not absolutely confirmed, that the new tower will contain one bedrooms and two bedrooms, maybe normal three bedrooms, maybe some other studios, but considering there are already so many studios, I wouldn't be surprised if they really focus in on one bedrooms and two bedrooms here. That being said, of course, for two bedrooms, unless they make them all dedicated, it would make sense to have some studios in the tower. That way you can have a mix of dedicated two bedrooms and lock off two bedrooms with those one bedrooms and studios next to each other in a lock off configuration. Also, based on the concept art that they released, which frankly, I don't know how closely that has to stay to current architecture and engineering plans, or if they have quite a lot of liberties and licenses and it'll end up looking very different. But anyway, based on this concept art, it does look to me personally like there are some different sized rooms here, with some smaller ones presumably being studios. We do not know anything about if they're planning on doing those two person only like tower studios. Again, like from the drawing, it's really hard to say. It doesn't look like anything is particularly tiny, but we'll just have to wait and see, I think. Also in this artist concept drawing, the further away wings look to be maybe about 6 stories of rooms, and then the tallest part of the tower looks to be maybe about 10-ish stories of rooms. Presumably the bottom floor or two is going to be more general use space in terms of dining, lobby, other things for all guests and not necessarily just rooms. Doing a rough count and a very rough estimate, I would guess you're gonna get maybe around 200 rooms in this tower. I think anything less than about 150 probably doesn't seem worth it. It can't be a particularly huge tower though, because you do have the monorail line sort of right behind you in that space, and they're definitely not doing monorail construction to make room for this tower. That would be ridiculous. And there's also been a lot of questions about how big the footprint of the tower will be. A lot of people are concerned that they're going to take away some longhouses that are near that area. And I don't think Disney has confirmed this, but I highly doubt they would do that. The longhouses are money. Why would you take those away to make a tower that's not going to replace all of those rooms plus more? Plus, in my opinion, they already have the square footage they need with this area of the Luau Cove and some of the greenery near it to get a tower in. The point of the tower is that it is dense, it's compact, it's smaller footprint and just taller to get more rooms in, as opposed to those traditional longhouses that are really not dense or compact. And like I said, Disney did confirm that the Spirit of Aloha show is going away, Luau Cove is going away, presumably to make room for this tower, so I think they already have the space planned out, and if they were going to close 3 of the longhouses, I think we would know about that. Other things we can glean from the drawing. So it does look like there's going to be a pool. You can see that on the left edge of the drawing, so that's exciting. Then on the bottom floor, sort of at the front of the tower, you can see a bunch of people sitting around. That could be a dining area. And then what looks to be on the second floor, there seems to be the semicircle area outside with some other folks. Maybe this is a lounge or a bar. Maybe it's a small dining experience. Who knows? The very top of the tower has these huge windows. It looks very beautiful. These could be grand villas. Personally, I'm hoping for a sort of top of the world lounge situation, but at the Poly. It's also entirely possible they make like a Topolino's Terrace, but Polynesian themed, so another Grand Californian-esque dining experience where you're at the top of a tallish building, you're gonna get great views, probably signature dining, but again, they haven't told us what the dining options will be. I do think it's safe to ascertain that there's gonna be something on the bottom floor based on the artist concept. I would guess it's a quick service or it may be a lower priced sit down, but yeah, if they were gonna put very expensive dining in here, I would think they would want to put it at the top of the tower. Like, part of the advantage of building a taller structure is those views, so if you're not going to give those to, yes, spending a ton of money or a ton of points, one would think you would want to entice people to come spend a ton of money on overpriced food and drinks for the view. The press release also didn't contain anything about transportation from this section of the resort, so it's possible that they add a new bus stop for those locations where you need a bus, so like Hollywood Studios you have to bus to. But in terms of the monorail, like, I highly doubt, personally, I don't think you're getting your own monorail station. I think you're going to have to go walk over to the Grand Ceremonial House. Right now, the current Polynesian DVC area, which is over by the TTC, does have its own bus stop, I believe, for Hollywood Studios and Animal Kingdom. So I do think it's possible that this new tower area, which is, like, further away, it's the opposite side of the resort, basically, may also get its own bus stop. But again, for the monorail, like, I think you're pretty much out of luck when it comes to that. Current DVC contracts at the Polynesian, so just those studios and bungalows that already exist, those contracts expire in 2066. Now, it wasn't clear from the press release, or it wasn't abundantly clear, at least, from the press release, whether or not the new tower set to open in late 2024 will be part of the same overall resort as the Polynesian DVC contracts already, or if they're going to treat it separately. So what I mean, for example, is with the Grand Floridian expansion, that is treated as the same as the prior Grand Flow contracts. So they all have the same expiration date, they all have the same access to all of those rooms, etc. In contrast, you have Copper Creek and Boulder Ridge, which are at the same resort, but are treated as separate Disney Vacation Club properties, so they have different expiration years. If you have a Boulder Ridge contract, you don't get priority access to Copper Creek, and vice versa. Disney has not said in extremely clear terms if the new Polynesian Tower will be part of the already existing Polynesian DVC resort and therefore take on that 2066 expiration year, and you would have equal access to tower rooms and the already existing bungalows and studios, or if they will be separate. If they are treated as separate, it's typically fairly safe to assume 50 years for contract expiration from any new build, so it's being built and supposed to open in late 2024, 50 years from that would be 2074, roughly, expiration. I personally think that they will be combined into one resort, because I also think that gives them the opportunity to reshuffle point allocations and maybe make the bungalows not such a weird situation where they're often kind of empty and they cost just way, way, way too many points. With the Polynesian DVC as it is right now, you only have studios and bungalows, so it's a little bit harder to redistribute points. But with a tower and an additional 200 rooms or so, and some of those being two bedrooms and one bedrooms, I think it's a lot easier to reallocate the points to make the use of all of those types of rooms appealing. The other thing that I think would be appealing to DVC, the corporation, about combining the tower into the existing contracts is you are then sticking with the 2066 expiration, so you're recouping a few years of time in terms of whenever they decide to resell or whatever they'll do when it expires. You don't have to wait those extra years to get that, which presumably is a shorter amount of time to make more money. So that's my personal opinion. That being said, I think the one clear caveat is that if they wanted to impose resale restrictions like they did on the Riviera, they couldn't do that if they combined the tower with the existing Polynesian resort. You would have to make a whole new resort to change those types of terms. So if they're really set on these resale restrictions like they implemented at Riviera, then the tower would have to be its own resort. But all in all, Disney Vacation Club hasn't said one way or the other, so we can speculate all we want, and I would love to hear your opinions in the comments down below, but we just don't know the facts yet. We also surely do not know the pricing or the points charts or any of those big factors that may sway your decision to buy in or not. The last thing I want to touch on is the aesthetics of the tower itself based on that artist concept image. This has quite the range of opinions based on what I've seen over on Twitter so far. Essentially, I think this very much goes with what I've been saying for a while, wherein I feel like Disney is moving towards generic looking buildings. Like, this could be a nice Marriott or a nice Hilton that you plopped on a beach on Waikiki. Personally, that doesn't bother me a ton. I think when you're talking about a timeshare, it does feel a little different if you're considering owning. Like, do you want to own at a generic looking building versus something more themed? I get that. But for general hotels, like, it doesn't really bother me, to be honest. I think a lot of people are very bothered. When you think about how it fits in with the resort overall, I'm the kind of person that is more like wait and see and let's not judge a drawing, but I do understand that hesitation in terms of you'll have the Great Ceremonial House, you'll have the longhouses, which are all very intricately themed and, you know, in a different mindset in terms of it's not about being dense and compact, it's way more sprawling. And then you're going to walk out towards the Grand Floridian, so up towards the wedding pavilion, I believe, and there'll be this massive tower. And so I do understand that that might be jarring. I think the theming on the exterior of the building, even if the architecture of the exterior doesn't really match, I think the theming could tie it in very well. Also, personally, I'm not too concerned about the exteriors for the most part. Like, if I'm staying there, I want to know, what is the dining? Is it good? Is it reasonably priced? Are there good drinks? And also, how are the rooms? Like, that's what I care about the most, is the interior of the rooms, how those are themed. I care a lot more about than the exterior of the building and, like, the comfort of the beds and the space itself and, like, does the layout make sense? That kind of stuff. But that tower style certainly is a departure from the original Polynesian architecture of those longhouses. And we are seeing this trend towards towers with Grandestino, Riviera, and now the Polynesian Tower. And I do think it just is about density and efficiency and getting more people in a smaller amount of space. I also enjoy living in big cities, so tower life really doesn't bother me. But yeah, let me know what you think. Try to be reasonable. Let's not, you know, be rude and attack anyone. And again, it is just an art of concept, and I think we should wait to fully judge it until it's actually built. But I am very excited about this overall, even if I'm not crazy about the exterior of the building. I know some people feel it's not worth the loss of Spirit of Aloha, and some people very strongly feel that the building is ugly and just shouldn't exist as is in the artist's concept. But I think getting more rooms, especially a mix of different room types, so adding in a bunch of one and two bedrooms at the Polynesian for Disney Vacation Club is massive and such a huge upgrade. Also, more dining options at the Poly is very exciting to me because I love what they have going on right now. So thinking about basically expanding those offerings to more awesome food and drinks makes me very excited. Definitely though, let me know what you think in the comments down below. I know I'm excited, but I want to hear from you. What are the huge pros and cons that you're seeing from this? Is this starting to make you think about maybe buying a Poly contract? And what are some details you definitely want more clarity on? Other than price, of course, I think we all want to know that. As the months go on, hopefully we learn more and more details, but ultimately, if they stick to this timeline, this resort's going to be open in less than 3 years, so it's coming pretty fast. As we learn more, I'll try to keep you updated. It may not always be a dedicated video like this, so definitely tune into my monthly creator updates for little bits of news that I think are worth sharing. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please hit that thumbs up button to like the video and consider subscribing to the channel. You can then ring the bell icon to receive notifications whenever I post new videos. Thanks so much for all of your interactions. I really appreciate it. I hope the rest of your day is magical, and we'll see you real soon at Pixie Dust PhD.